What's good, everybody? This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters. Today, guys, we're going to be talking about solving inequalities. But before we get started, I want to ask you all to like our videos, subscribe to our channel, and to leave any comments for future videos you guys would like to see. All right, so what is an inequality? An inequality is just an equation with an inequality symbol. And the way that we solve inequalities, guys, is the same exact way as we solve equations. The only difference is the inequality sign. So we should know that we have a less than sign, greater than sign, less than or equal to, and greater than or equal to sign. Okay? And when we're solving inequalities, as I said before, it's the same exact steps as an equation. All right? So when we look at the problem below, 3x plus 2 is less than negative 4. What we want to do is to isolate x, right? Get it by itself on one side of the inequality and have the constants on the opposite side. So I'm going to want to move that positive 2 over to the other side of the inequality symbol using the same steps, right? Inverse operations to solve. So plus 2, the opposite of adding 2 is subtracting 2, right? So we subtract 2 from itself to cancel it out. And then we want to go on the opposite side of the inequality symbol and subtract 2 from its like term. So now we have 3x is less than negative 4 plus negative 2, which is negative 6, right? We added those like terms. Now, for us to get that x by itself, right, we're multiplying 3 and x, and we know we're trying to get to the number 6. So the opposite, right, of multiplying is just divide. So if we want to get this x by itself, we're going to divide by 3, right? Divide 3 by itself, and we're going to the opposite side and divide negative 6 by 3. And once we do that, we should have an answer of x is less than negative 2. Right? Same exact steps as an equation. However, there is one key difference when it comes to solving inequalities. And the difference is this. When we multiply and divide by a negative x, we have to flip our inequality symbol. And this is what I mean. So let's switch colors. So we have the problem negative 7x plus 8 is less than or equal to 1. Right? We have the same exact goal. We want to figure out what x is, so we have to get it by itself on one side of the inequality. So I'm going to focus on canceling and moving 8 over to the other side of the inequality. So the opposite of adding 8 is subtracting 8, right? So we're going to subtract 8 from itself. That cancels out. And I want to go on the other side and do the same step. So now we have negative 7x is less than or equal to negative 7, right? And the goal is still the same, figure out what x is. So at this step, guys, we're going to divide. So I divide by negative 7, right? That's going to give me x by itself, and then I'm going to go on the other side and divide negative 7 by negative 7. And guys, this is what I'm talking about right here. So you see how our x was negative and we divided, right? Negative 7x. Because we divided by a negative x, our inequality symbol is going to flip. So now, instead of being less than or equal to, x is greater than or equal to negative 7 divided by negative 7, which is just positive 1. Okay? So when you divide by a negative x, guys, flip your inequality symbol. Now, let's look at a problem where we multiply by a negative x and we have to do that same sign flip. So we have the problem x over 8 negative, right? Minus 5 is less than negative 2. And what I want you guys to understand is a fraction is considered one number. So even though the negative is not in front of x, that entire fraction is negative, okay? So when I go to start solving, right, same thing. We're going to want to probably bring that 5 over to the other side so we could work on getting the variable by itself. So I add 5, right? Add 5 to both sides. And what I have here is negative x over 8 is less than positive 3, right? And in, to get rid of our negative now, what I'm going to do is I want to multiply by negative 8 over 1, right? So we could get rid of that fraction. Our 8s cancel out. All we're left with is x on that left-hand side. And then I'm going to multiply by negative 8 on the other side, right? So now, 3 times negative 8 is going to give us negative 24. But what about this inequality symbol? Did you guys notice how we multiplied by a negative x, right? So once we do that, our sign has to flip. So our new answer would be x is greater than negative 24. So guys, just remember, when you're solving inequalities, same exact steps as solving an equation, but when the x is negative and we multiply or divide by that negative, we must flip that inequality symbol. Thank you guys for joining us today. This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters. Join us next time.